That was pretty cool. Interesting artwork. Yeah, I'm sure someone will want to have this in their collection. Oh, hello. And welcome to Miskatonic Secondhand Records and CDs. How can I help you? Yes, unfortunately, the rumors are true. Just give me a second. Someone just brought in this used CD. The band tool, Fear Inoculum. Put that aside for a moment. But I'm sure you've seen the news and heard all the reports with that new world order. And now they've put a ban on the sale and distribution of music. It's crazy. It just boggles my mind. It's very surreal to even think about. But every known music store across the world has been closed. And this is actually the final hour of this store as well. I'm sure you couldn't help but notice the two armed militia out front, just waiting for me to close up shop. Then after that, they'll come and seize everything and take it to their warehouse. It's just like what happened with the ban on sugar. And now all the candy stores went out of business. Soda, even things like, ketchup, barbecue sauce, can't have sugar in it anymore. I don't know what's going on with the world. It's quite frightening, to be honest. I mean, first, this, how did this new world order come to be anyway? All the different governments across the globe just unanimously decided to form coalesce into one new entity. And what's really weird is the fact that William Clemens, that doctor up at Arkham Sanitarium, which isn't that far from here, he is the leader of this new world order, this new global government. He says that the idea is to make the world a better place for everyone. Getting rid of sugar, too much sugar, too much entertainment, banning music. It's crazy. It's ridiculous. I mean, I'm sure you've seen, all the news reports, the riots, the protests. But when you're armed with a militia, like this new world order is, well, those protests don't last long. So, it's crazy. I mean, what's next? Are they going to ban the formation of musical bands and listening to the radio? They haven't done that yet. Are they going to ban instruments? And then what's after that? Banning movies, video games, everything and anything. It's really scary times, but I don't want to get you all somber. So as I say, this is the last time that we'll be open, closing in just under an hour now. Everything for sale in the bins is now half off. So records are $5 and CDs are $2. Okay. Have you had a chance to look around or anything? These? Oh, well, these are just a selection of the used records. And I usually rotate these every month. Well, used to rotate them every month. Now that we're closing down for good, that's not going to happen anymore. So this is the final rotation. And all I would do is just take a random selection from what we sell and just put them up here, you know, change it every month or a couple weeks, you know, give people that are coming up and buying a chance to see something they might not normally look for. So, are you interested in any of these? Yeah? Okay. Well, why don't I just go through what I have on display here, and maybe a couple of the CDs as well, and you can decide for yourself if you're interested in any of them, okay? All right. What I was just looking at? Oh. Someone, a previous customer, just brought this in to trade. This is the album by the band Tool called Fear Inoculum. Have you ever heard of the band or listened to any of their albums, songs? Yeah? Okay. This particular album took about 13 years for them to release. Not that it took them 13 years to write it, but it just took them a while to release this album or their next album. And while it's not anything groundbreaking or really new, you know, it really is, I guess you could say, they've really defined their own style with this, refined, you could say. So, and I hope you don't mind me tapping like this. These are stressful times, and I find it helps me a lot, and some of the customers find it helps them to relax and puts them in a nice, calm state of mind while they're shopping. So, but, yeah, this particular CD, you open it up. And it will automatically play a video and some music, which is, I think, separate from the actual recorded studio songs. And you get some artwork. So this is, you can turn the volume up or down. You can actually recharge it with the USB charger. You can pause it as well. Pretty unique. I don't think that's ever been done before. So quite artistic, which is the nature of the band. Some cool artwork. And there is a another booklet. Well, this is actually the CD case. There is a particular artist, I forget his name offhand, that they collaborate with, does a lot of the art for them. Here's the back. Here's the booklet. It does have the lyrics to all the songs in it, which is cool. Front, that's the back, and just a little glimpse at the artwork inside. Okay, so that's available for sale. Like I said, all CDs are available for sale for $2, so half the price. It is used, it's in good condition, no scratches, okay? So what do you think, interested? Yeah? Okay, this will be the first sale. All right, $2 so far. So, would you like to see some of the albums? Yeah? Okay. Any particular, or... No, you don't care? Alright. I'll just start here. Right, and we'll go left. Let's see. We have, blues musician Muddy Waters. And just so you know, you will get the protective sleeve that all the used albums come in, but most of them, okay? So this is the best of Muddy Waters. You familiar with him? He's a very influential blues musician. They even refer to him as the father. Of Chicago blues, modern Chicago blues. And I'm not sure if you're, I don't get too much into the history of all the genres of music, but, you know, Chicago blues is more of a modern electronic, you might say, you know, electric guitars and things like that, a version of Delta blues, with which was more rural and acoustic, which originated around the Delta of Mississippi. So a lot of the African Americans, you know, the black folks, migrated north, some, you know, to Chicago, and they established Chicago blues. And Muddy Waters was one of those musicians. So, this is the best of Muddy Waters. Tells a little bit about him on the back. And just so you know how influential Muddy Waters was, the Rolling Stones got their name from one of his songs titled Rolling Stone. AC/DC's song, You Shook Me All Night Long. That's inspired from the song, You Shook Me. So, all right, so on side A, we have, I Just Want to Make Love to You, or AKA, Just Make Love to Me, Long Distance Call, Louisiana Blues, Honey Bee, Rolling Stone, like I said previously, I'm Ready, Evans Shuffle, Too Young to Know, and then on side B, I'm your hoochie coochie man. She moves me. I want you to love me, aka mad love. Standing around crying. Still a fool. I can't be satisfied. She's so pretty. And I feel like going home. So 16 tracks. And this is 180 gram LP. Alright, so what do you think? $5. Interested in purchasing it? Yeah? Okay. Alright, let me put the sleeve back on. Alright, there you have it. Muddy Waters. Put that down here on the counter for you. Along with your tool CD. Okay, what's next? About Metallica. This is Metallica's Ride the Lightning. It's their second studio album. And this is where they really begin to grow as musicians. A lot of different themes with their music and lyrics. So they're not about any one particular theme. You know, like horror or anything like that. Nothing really satanic too much. Of course you have Ride the Lightning, title track, kind of about the death penalty. Show you the back here. Here you can see the photos of the band from back in the day, back in the 80s. James Hetfield, Kirk Hammett, Lars Ulrich, and rest in peace, Cliff Burton. All right, side one, we have Fight Fire with Fire, Ride the Lightning, For Whom the Bell Tolls, Fade to Black, which is somewhat in the style of Lynyrd Skynyrd's Free Bird. Side two, we have Trapped Under Ice and Escape. Those two songs are right. Creeping Death, very popular song. And the instrumental, The Call of Cthulhu. So, Ride the Lightning is available if you're interested in. Yeah? Okay. All right. Put that back in the sleeve for you. See what we have next. This is the triple album release, the third studio album by Smashing Pumpkins, Melancholy, and the Infinite sadness. So this too is used and is $5. It's a really good bargain. Of course, I'm trying to sell everything, give people a chance to buy whatever they might not have before. You won't be able to buy anything ever again. So, comes in this nice box. And you also receive a couple of booklets. I believe there is a lyric book as well as an art book. Photographs and art. Let's see. Biography, I believe. Yeah. So this is, it's an art book. Just an inside glimpse. It's photos and art done by the band, for the band, as well as some info, like a biography, about the band or this particular album or release. See if there's anything in here I can show you. Some blurbs in here. There's a few paragraphs in here, but it's okay. I won't take up too much time. We don't have too much time left. Just about a half an hour or so before we close shop permanently. Just put this back in here. And I'll just take out one of the albums. This is the album release. It has a lot of the hits on it. This is side E and side F. This is the third one. It has tracks Where Boys Fear to Tread, Bodies, 33, In the Arms of Sleep, 1979, one of the singles, great song, Tales of a Scorched Earth, Through the Eyes of Ruby. So they are alternative, grunge, kind of rock band. Like I said, I don't have time to take out every album there, but this is available for $5. Interested? Yeah? Okay. All right, and that is yours. Okay, see what we have next for you. How about the first solo album by Lauryn Hill? The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill. She, this is her first solo album after her work in the band The Fugees. This album, I guess you could say, her as well. Considered hip-hop, some R&B, and even some reggae. A lot of different themes on love, God, and some of the turmoil from within the band, the Fugees, she was once a member of. I would say a great singer, but you know, I would say that for anybody. If you are a fan of music in general, like I am, and you like all types, there's a few subgenres I'm not a fan of, but I like everything, almost. Country, new age, bluegrass, you know, how can you not like all the different types of music, you know? Variety is the spice of life, as they say. So here's the back, all right? And this is 180 grams, two albums, two LPs. Let's see, side one, you have an intro, Lost Ones, X Factor, two, Zion, and not meaning to a place called Zion. That's dedicated to her first and eldest son, whose name is Zion. Next track, Doo-Wop, That Thing. Side 2, Superstar, Final Hour, When It Hurts So Bad, I Used to Love Him. Side 3, Forgive Them, Father, Every Ghetto, Every City, Nothing Even Matters. And then side 4, Everything Is Everything, and The Miseducation, or the title track, The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill. So, great voice, great album. If you like blues, hip-hop, you know, R&B, kind of mixed together, I think you might enjoy this one. What do you say? Yeah? All right. Okay. Let's get this back into the sleeve. There's another one for you and your collection. Okay, let's see what we have next. Of course. The album Rain and Blood by the thrash metal band Slayer, who I mentioned earlier when I was talking about Metallica. Ride the Lightning. This was a critically acclaimed album. Slayer, very influential pioneer of the thrash metal genre. And I have to say, personally, one of my favorite albums by them. I think this is their third. There's Hell Awaits, was one of their prior albums. I can't think of what the other one might have been. I think this is their third release. Great artwork on the cover. And then on the back, picture of the band from back in the 80s, 1980s. All right, and I will read off the track listing. Side 1, Angel of Death, which was quite controversial. When it came out, a lot of folks thought the band supported Nazism and all this because of the lyrical content, misconceptions of that song, which is referenced to Josef Mengele and Auschwitz back in World War II. But yeah, Angel of Death, Piece by Piece, Necrophobic, Altar of Sacrifice, Jesus Saves, Side 2, Criminally Insane, Reborn, Epidemic, Postmortem, and somewhat the title track, Raining Blood. The album is called Rain in Blood. But the title track, you would say, is Raining Blood. So, definitely an album that should be in everyone's collection, if you ask me. What about you? Yeah, definitely? Okay. Here's your total so far. Put this back in the sleeve for you. There you have it. Your very own Rain in Blood by Slayer. Okay. Just put that there with the rest of your albums and your Tool CD. See what we have next for you. How about the essential Johnny Cash. This is two LPs, 180 gram each. And there are, how many tracks is that? 15, 21, 28 tracks on all four sides. Let's take this out of the sleeve, get a better look at it. Now, I'm not sure if you're familiar with Johnny Cash, the legend, but his style is country, blues, folk, rockabilly, and even some gospel. Known for that iconic, deep baritone bass vocals of his. So, there's the front. You got a good look at that. And there is the back with him when he was a lot younger, performing on stage. Okay. The track listing is a 180 gram LP. All the LPs, most of them, you know, are 180 grams, so you know you're getting a good quality LP. Track listing for you. A lot of the classics here. Side A, we have Hey Porter, Cry, 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 I Walk the Line, Get Rhythm, There You Go, Ballad of a Teenage Queen, Big River, Guess Things Happen That Way. Side B, All Over Again, Don't Take Your Guns to Town, 5 Feet High and Rising, The Rebel, Johnny Yuma, Tennessee Flat Top Box, I Still Miss Someone, and The Ring of Fire. Side C, The Ballad of Ira Hayes, Orange Blossom Special, It Ain't Me, Babe, with June Carter Cash, The One on the Right is on the Left, Jackson with June Carter Cash, and Folsom Prison Blues Live. Side D, Daddy Sang Bass, Girl from the North Country with Bob Dylan, A Boy Named Sue Live, if I were a carpenter, with June Carter Cash, Sunday Morning Coming Down, Man in Black, which is how, I think in his later years, he would wear all black and performing on stage. And then the final track is One Piece at a Time. So that is the best of Johnny Cash. Just another must-have in anyone's collection who is a lover of music. So what do you say? $5, get you Johnny Cash's greatest hits. Yeah? All right. Okay, put this back in the sleeve. See what next for you. Getting close to closing time for good here. So, see. We have a picture disc by the band Merciful Fate. I'm not going to take this out because it is just this clear cover with the album inside. Not sure if you're familiar with Merciful Fate, one of the earliest heavy metal, black metal bands, one of the first that were a part of the first wave of black metal back in the 80s, and fronted by none other than the iconic King Diamond, who went on to create, produce albums under self-titled King Diamond band with some members from Merciful Fate. But this was his first band, I believe, or first real band, you would say, official band. There was Melissa. This is the debut album. A lot of occult and satanic themes. And if you're not familiar with King Diamond, he is known for his elaborate stage productions, especially in the later years, storytelling with his King Diamond albums. A lot of each album is almost like an entire story, kind of like Pink Floyd's The Wall. And of course, he's known for his falsetto style of singing. His vocal range, he doesn't really do growling too much, but can hit the high notes. It's pretty amazing. I'll never forget the first time I heard this album, which introduced me to King Diamond. I was just blown away. I was like, is that a guy singing? And then I was, 15-year-old at the time, just finding out about heavy metal for the first time. And this was one of the first albums I discovered. I was a Catholic schoolboy at the time. So heavy metal and all the types of lyrics, the occult and Satan and all that were just shockingly new to me. So, and it's just music, it's just words, it's art, that's all it is. show you the back, just a few band photos there, right? Such a classic cover, really. Such a great piece of art, and that's one of the great things about albums, is all the different artwork. Okay, side one, Evil, Curse of the Pharaohs, Into the Coven, At the Sound of the Demon Bell. Side two, Black Funeral, Satan's Fall, and Melissa. And Satan's Fall is like an 11-minute opus of a song, you might say. It's like a dozen different riffs in that song. So there you go, Merciful Fate, Melissa. You interested? Yeah? Okay. $5. Okay. All right, getting really close to closing up here. I can see the militia keep looking in. All right, we have just a couple more albums to look at. This is Beastie Boys' second or third release. I think it might be their third. Check Your Head. Just take this out of the sleeve. And just in case you're not familiar with them, they are, you would say, or they were, a mix of rock, hip-hop, punk rap, rap rock, a combination of all those types of genres or sub-genres, and known for their almost somewhat serious yet comical lyrics. This is the first album where they actually used more of their own instruments and less sampling. So each member, I forget exactly their names offhand, except for Adam Yauch, rest in peace. But one of them played guitar, bass, and drums. All right, so that's the front. And we have the back. And, you know, this one actually opens up. We have the albums inside. And this one happens to open up. Right. There's the back. And we'll go over the track listing here. Let's see, side A, Jimmy James, Funky Boss, Pass the Mic, Gratitude, and Lighten Up. Side B, Finger Licking Good, So What You Want. That's one of their, known for one of those songs. The Biz Versus the Nuge. I think that's how you pronounce that. Time for Living, Something's Got to Give. The Blue Nun, Stand Together. POW, or POW. The Maestro, Groove Homes. That was side C. Then side D, Live at PJ's, Mark on the Bus, Professor Booty, In Threes, and Namaste. So there you have it. Beastie Boys check your head. So what do you think? You interested? Yeah, all right. I have to say, you're my favorite customer, probably of all time. Okay, put this back in the sleeve. And really, I do mean that. You are my favorite customer out of all the customers I've ever customered. All right. Another one for your collection. Okay, how about that last album? Okay, then we got just a few minutes left and time to close up shop for good. Oh, and there is one more album I forgot. Jam's debut album, if I'm not mistaken, 10. This has a lot of the, three of their more well-known songs. Even Flow, Jeremy, and Alive. I think that's right. The track listing is on the inside. So if you're interested in this one, again, it's $5. Yeah? Okay. One of the very influential, great grunge alternative rock bands. I'd go into a little bit more about them, but like I said, we're running out of time here. All right, last album. This is The Misfits. This is actually a collection from their first two albums, two or three. I'll take this out of the sleeve. So there's the front cover. And I'm not sure if you're familiar with the Misfits. They are, I would say, a combination of a few different genres, heavy metal, punk rock, and horror punk. I believe they were founded by Glenn Danzig, who went off to form his own band under the name Danzig. Jerry Only, another member of the Misfits, and Doyle Wolfgang von Frankenstein, who also went off to form his own band. I think the latest one was Doyle, if I'm not mistaken. So that is the front cover. And then we have the back. Track listing. This also contains some previously unreleased versions of the songs. And if you've never listened to the Misfits before, it's probably a good way to get into them, be introduced to their work. All right, track one, She, Hollywood Babylon, Bullet, Horror Business, Teenagers from Mars, Night of the Living Dead, Where Eagles Dare, Vampire, I Turned Into a Martian, and Skulls. Track side two, London Dungeon, Ghouls Night Out, Astro Zombies, Mommy, Can I Go Out and Kill Tonight? Die, Die, My Darling, Earth AD, Devil Lock, Death Comes Ripping, Green Hell, and Wolf's Blood. Green Hell and Die, Die, My Darling are two of the tracks covered by Metallica. Among maybe others might have covered the Misfits as well, but I just know that Metallica has. So, there you have it. I put this back in the sleeve. You interested in this one as well? Yeah, okay. Alright, so that's your new total. How would you like to pay? I accept cash, credit, no checks, of course. You know what, though? Just add this to your collection here. Just give me a second. Alright. Alright, so here you go. All the albums that you've purchased, as well as that Tool CD, okay? Here you go. You can have them right here. Tell you what. I know. Guys, can you just give me a second? You don't need to point your guns at me. Let me just finish up here, and I'll close up. All right? Thank you. Tell you what. Since this is my last transaction ever, and the last sale of albums and CDs ever, you can have it for free. Okay? So just clear this out. You don't have to worry about it. It's on me, on the house. All right? Hey, the pleasure was all mine. I appreciate your business, so to speak. And, you know, like I said, with this being the last time there will ever be a record sale, you know, it's the least I can do. So hold on to them. Hopefully, there's no plans on confiscating people's personal property. Hopefully, the world won't come to that. I don't know what's in store for us. But all these bands, it's not looking good. So, all right, well, thanks again, and good luck. Take care of yourself. And yeah, fellas, I'm finishing up here, okay? Take care of yourself. Now, I gotta go and close up. All right. So long. All right. Well, old friend, I guess this is it. Turn this off here. All right. So long to you too. We had a lot of good memories together, didn't we? Yeah. Right. I don't know what they're going to be doing with you, but take care of yourself as well. Alright, fellas. You can come in, close up, take everything, and whatever you're going to do to that warehouse for forever. Alright. So long, old place.